Hello, ladies and gentlemen. It's a pleasure to be here in this in this beautiful hotel, ladies and gentlemen. My name is CAHAL. That's Irish for Charlie. And, Charlie Dunne. It's alcohol without the al. So that's the best way, ladies and gentlemen. And I've been in America about 24 years, and without a shadow of a doubt, I've been fortunate enough to travel around the world a few times, and I know without any doubt this is the greatest country I have ever been in. And I can sum you up in six easy but very profound words. What can I do for you? That is how you are, and I love you for that. And I appreciate this beautiful hotel, and thank you for being so kind to me. I just want to check out one little quick thing. How are you singing tonight? All right? So here are four beautiful Irish songs just to get us starting off, Lidon. But one quick question. Do you like the tux? Proudly made in America, ladies and gentlemen. Proudly made in America. Made in my home state of Pennsylvania. We live in Pittsburgh. So there we go. Pittsburgh Steelers, etc. Okay. So anyway, just want to check out how you're singing. And here we go. There's a tear in your eye and a wondering why. Sure, it never should be there at all. With such power in your smile, sure, a stone you beguile, so that never a teardrop should fall. With such sweet lilting laughter like some fairy song, and your eyes shining bright as can be, you can laugh all the while and all other times smile. Won't you please smile a sweet smile for me? When Irish eyes are smiling, sure 'tis like a morning spring. Your turn. You can hear the angels sing when Irish hearts are happy. All the world seems bright and gay. And when sure they'll steal your, ladies and gentlemen, it's going to be a good night. Over in Killarney many years ago, my mother sang the song to me in tones so sweet and low. Just a simple Irish ditty in her good old Irish way. And I'd give the world if I could hear her sing the song today. Key of D. Tooralooralura, Tooralooralai, Tooralooralura. Hush now, don't you cry. Tooralooralura, Tooralooralura. An Irish. Thank you. There's a spot in my heart couch which no Colleen may own. There's a gut to my face never sounded or known. There's a place in my memory, my life that you fill. No other can take it, no one ever will. Sure, I love the dear silver that shines in your hair, and the brow that's all furrowed and wrinkled with care. I kiss the dear fingers so toil-worn for me. Oh, God bless you and keep you, Mother McCree. And the last one, my wife. The sweetest flower that grows, you may search everywhere, but none can compare to my wild Irish rose. Your turn. The sweetest flower that grows, and someday for my sake she may let me take the bloom from my wild Irish rose. Oh, yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Okay. Let's get those hands clapping, everybody. Come on. Woo. Oh, yeah. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. If you're Irish, come into the parlor. There's a welcome there for you. And if your name is Timothy or Pat, as long as you come from Ireland, there's a welcome on the mat. If you come from the mothers of Mona, Killarney's lakes so blue, and we'll sing you a song, we'll make a fuss. Whoever you are, you're one of us. If you're Irish, this is the place for you. Hello. And the name is McNamara, I'm the leader of the band. We're the finest in the land, and we play at wakes, high weddings, and at every con. Hello. And when we play a funerals, we play the march from Saul. Oh, the drums go bang and the cymbals,
and the country fade away. Around the film, the Irish, the film, the way.
And Hennessy, Tennessee, tootle the fruit, and the music is something grand. Hi, a credit to all Ireland is a fine. La 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 la, hi. La 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 la, sir. La 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 la. Key of G. La 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 la, hi. La 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 la, la. A credit to all Ireland is McNamara's band. How are you? Ah, me name is Uncle Julius, I'm from Sweden. I'd have come to play in McNamara's and beat the big bass drum. Hi. And when we march along the streets, the ladies think I'm grand. They say there's Uncle Julius playing in McNamara's band. I wear a bunch of shamrocks and a uniform of green. Hi, I am the funniest looking Swede. Good day, sir. Hi there. But by Yemeni, I'm the only Swede in McNamara's band. Ah, the drums go bang and the cymbals clang and the horns they blaze away. McCarthy pumps the old bassoon and Doyle the pipes to play. And Hennessy, Tennessee, tootle the flute, and the music is something grand. A credit to all Ireland is last time. La 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 la. Hup, hup. La 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 la. La 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 la. La 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 la. A credit to all Ireland is McNamara's band. Oh yeah. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, very, 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 very much. We have champion step dancers now for your pleasure, ladies and gentlemen. They have been over to Ireland competing against the Irish at their own game and have beaten them. And they're superb. For your pleasure, please welcome Casey and Sarah. Thank you very, very much. Here they are. Look at that. Wow. It's Casey and Sarah, ladies and gentlemen. Aren't they superb? Okay. Thank you, ladies. They're going to be back shortly, ladies and gentlemen. They're going to be back shortly, and when you have eaten your dinner, I would welcome all the people that have a sort of a wall in between here just to come over and you can have and look at their magic feet, you know. Ladies and gentlemen, when I came here first 24 years ago, I was, to be honest with you, I was pretty lonely. And when I was feeling sorry for myself, I wrote this little song called Home Again. And I know that a lot of you are eating right now, but I'm going to teach it to you, if you don't mind. It's very, very simple. The first words are in the chorus, and then we'll smile for a little while, live for a little while, like old times. And this is how it goes.
And then we'll smile for a little while, live for a little while, like old times.
Could you try that?
And then we'll smile for a little while, live for a little while, like old times.
That's very, very good, and you're all sober, I know that. Second half, someday I'll buy a one-way back to my home again.
Someday I'll buy a one-way back to my home again.
When I win the lottery. We have a lottery in Ireland now, you know, ladies and gentlemen, and the money is pretty good. It's $1 million, $2 million, $3 million every week. And the nice thing about Ireland is if you win the lottery, you get it all. There's no tax taken from you. Yeah, the government, I suppose, hasn't figured out that you can give and take at the same time. But Pat and Mary, we were watching the little balls go up the chutes. They were in Dublin on the television. And she said, Pat, she said, if you ever won the lottery, Pat, would you still love me? Of course I would, Mary. I'd miss you, but I'd still love you, though. But you know, so here we go. Kia C, ladies and gentlemen, Home Again. Hope you like it.
Come hear the wind blow and breathe the air so fresh and clean, so wild and free, with deep emotion we dry our tears now. Home again, we're home. My home now, through traveled eyes now, looks so small to what I've seen, but I belong there. When we're home again, and then we'll smile for a little while, live for a little while, like old times. Someday I'll buy a one-way back to my home. Again. again. We're home again. And then we'll smile for a little while, live for a little while like old times. Someday I'll buy a one-way back to my home.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, very, 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 very much. I was telling you about Pat and the lottery, ladies and gentlemen. Shh, just for a sec. About 6 months later, would you believe it, Pat won the whole thing, £3 million. And Pat was still slogging away at work, and she got the call. What they couldn't do with the money, they could pay off the mortgage, change the banger of a car, and they were thrilled. Oh, dear God, she thought about Pat's bad heart. And if she blurted out in her hyper way, Pat might drop dead on the spot, and that'd be no good for anybody. So she thought the best person to break the news gently to Pat was Father Casey. He was delighted to come over. Mary was a grand old cook. And after dinner, they're inside in the drawing room with the cigars and the brandies. And he said to him, Pat, he said, did you hear about that lottery today? God, I did, Father. Wasn't it an awful lot of money? £3 million? It certainly was, Pat, he said. If you won that money now, Paddy said, what would you do with that money? Well, now, Father, he said, if I won that money, the first thing I'd do is I'd give you half of it. And Father Casey dropped dead. Here's a little piece, ladies and gentlemen, by a brilliant man, the greatest genius of them all, Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. If anybody here has a bit of German in you, you should be very proud of this guy. And it's a symphony number 40 in G minor, second movement, not quite played the way he wrote it, but he's dead, so what can he do? So here we go, a little piece by, as his wife called him, Wolfie. Honest to God, that's true. Thank you. very, 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 very much. However, poor old Mozart just turned in his grave. Ladies and gentlemen, my mother and father, Gerard and Rena Dunne, if you knew them, I believe you'd like them. My mother stayed at home with the five of us, and Dad was a teacher, and there was five of us, and they, in fairness, they held hands all their lives, which I thought was great. If they ever let go, they'd kill each other. But they'd have a little party about twice a month in our house, and Mum would cook a lovely dessert like supper, and then they'd go into the living room. We lived in Cork City in a small little row house that they now call a townhouse. We didn't realize we were posh at the time, you know. But everybody would start singing, and Dad would jump on the piano, and he'd start accompanying everybody. And then he'd sing his little party piece. And as a little tribute to my father, I put it on my new CD. And when we were up in New York recording it last year, one of the lads, the harmonica player, said, "I remember that song. That was a huge hit for the Harmonicats here in the 50s. So you know it as well as, of course, it's called Peg of My Heart. So if there are any Peggies or Margarets here, especially for you. And if you sing, please sing in my key, which is B-flat. Because you're very close to me. All right. So here we go. There's a real nice verse. You may not know the verse, but it's really nice. Here we go. I got tired of a song if it lingers too long, and roses I've plucked and thrown away, but still I never change my tune when we are strolling neath the moon. Pretty Peg, can't you see heaven sent you to me? I need you much more than I can say. I know I'm aiming high, but a dreamer can try. So why can't I just dream and sigh? My love song, Peg of my heart, we'll never part. I always knew it would be you. Since I heard your lilting laughter, it's your Irish heart I'm after, Peg of my heart. Your glances make my heart say, how's chances, come be my own, and come make your home in my heart. Every beautiful rose, every violet knows I love her, I love her, yes I do. Although her heart is far away, I know I'll make her mine someday. Pretty Peg, can't you see heaven sent you to me? I need you much more than I can say. And her heart fondly sighs as I sing to her eyes of blue, sweet eyes of blue, let's hear you. I love you, we'll never part. I always knew it would be you. Your turn. Peg of my heart, your glances make my heart say, how's chances, come be my own, come make your home in my heart. Oh yeah. And her heart fondly sighs as I sing to her eyes of blue, sweet eyes of blue. Last time, let's hear you. Peg of my heart, I love you, we'll never part. I always knew it would be you.
voice, I heard your lilting laughter. It's your Irish heart I'm after, plague of my heart. Your glances make my heart say, how's chances? Come be my own, and come make your home in my heart.
Really, really nice. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Peg of my heart. Mr. and Mrs. Shanahan, ladies and gentlemen, they were from County Kerry, and they were up on a week's visit to Dublin. And it was interrupted by an emergency visit to the dentist. And she said, doctor, she said, got a big bad tooth in the back of the mouth. It's rotting. We need to get it out. Don't worry about the pain. We don't have time for the anesthetic. Just yank it out. Do what you have to do, and we'll be on our way. And the dentist said, my God, Mr. Shannon, I'm very impressed with your courage. Which tooth is it? And she looked at her husband and said, show him the old tooth there, will you? And Danaher was a waiter in Killarney. He was serving this very nice couple one evening. And he noticed that the man suddenly just go pale as a ghost. And he slid under the table and vanished behind the tablecloth. And the lady said, madam, he said, I just want to let you know that your husband just slipped under the table. She said, no, actually, my husband just walked in the door. Would you like to hear Danny Boy, ladies and gentlemen? I don't know that one. You'd kill me if I didn't know that one. Danny Boy is one of the finest folk songs there is, I believe. And it's a father saying goodbye to his final son, Danny, before he goes off to do his part for Ireland's freedom a long, long time ago. And according to this legend, his two older brothers had been killed in a previous uprising. So his dad pours his heart out to his little boy and hopes and prays he'll be back safe and well. And of course, he'll be there to greet him when he does. But if he's not, for Danny to find his resting place and say a little prayer over his grave, and he will sense it wherever we go next. And I do believe it resonates so well in this country because so many of you, mostly gentlemen, have done exactly the same for your country, the veterans. So in my favorite key on the piano, the key of C, let's sing Danny Boy together 2 days before St. Patrick's Day. Okay, here we go. Thank you.
The pipes are calling from glen to glen and down the mountainside. The summer's gone and all the roses falling. Tis you must go and I must bide, but come ye back. When summer's in the meadow, oh, when the valley's hushed and white with snow, 'tis I'll be here in sunshine or in shadow. Oh, Danny boy, oh, Danny boy, I love you so. And if he comes and all flowers are dying, if I am dead as dead I well may be. Please come and find the place where I am lying, and kneel and say an ave there for me, and I shall hear. Soft you tread above me, and all my grave shall warmer, sweeter be, if you will bend and tell me that you love me. Then I shall sleep in peace until you come to me.
Yeah, how lovely. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, Danny Boy. I never get tired of singing that song. Ladies and gentlemen, a quick little challenge now. I know that you're very sophisticated and all that sort of stuff, but I want you to sing this little bit of Irish nonsense, good fun, good, clean, innocent nonsense. This is a little song called Give the Woman in the Bed More Porter. Porter, P-O-R-T, not a quarter, porter, which is, of course, stout, generally in Ireland, Guinness. But where I come from, down further south, Murphy's, much better, but that's another story. And in the old days, in the old countries in Europe, including Ireland, as you know, large families were the norm. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 wasn't too unusual. But Mr. and Mrs. O'Brien, 100 years ago, they had 18 children. Can you imagine having... And she was a little bit hyper, the poor thing. A little bit, yeah. And Valium had not been invented yet, unfortunately. So they had to give her the forerunner to the sleeping tablet, which was, of course, porter. Gallons of porter, apparently, so that she could sleep through the roaring, snoring, shouting, whining, whinging, fighting, bedwetting. And so that was just her husband. So if you wouldn't mind, you sing the chorus, which is Give the Woman in the Bed More Porter 3 times, and then the best line in it, before she wrecks the house. Because if she wakes up at all, she goes mad altogether. Now, this is your part, ladies and gentlemen. Key of F, if anybody's worried about your key. Goes like this. Give the woman in the bed more porter. Give the woman in the bed more porter. Give the woman in the bed more porter before she wrecks the house. That's pretty simple, isn't it? Now, Mrs. O'Brien was a little bit deaf as well. And that probably explains the 18 children, you see. Because every night when her husband got into bed, he said, well, will we go to sleep? Or what? And she'd go, what? And suddenly... O'Brien was a friend of mine. He had a mighty wife. She bred him 18 children through the years of joy and strife. When her temper started rising, she would turn a blazing red. And she'd maybe break a bowl or two as she thundered off to bed. Give the woman in the bed more porter. Give the woman in the bed more porter. Give the woman in the bed more porter. You have it? She had her fill of porter, then she began to snore, and the bed would shake and rattle as it thundered on the floor. O'Brien manned the kitchen as the blankets flew about, then he'd run like heck to get more drink as she began to shout. Give the woman in the bed more porter. Give the woman in the bed more porter. Wrecks the house. On your own, the next chorus now, I dare you. Well, the doctors tried for years and years to cool her temper down. They fed her herbs and potions and powders by the pound. But the man who cured her temper, a scutcher, Paddy Mallon, said to keep her cool, you've got to feed her porter by the gallon. Give the woman in the bed more porter. That is excellent. In fairness, your rhythm, diction, pitch, perfect. All I can say is the nuns did a very good job at some of you. If there's any nuns here tonight, well done, sisters. Okay. Oh, and she had her fill of porter, then she began to sing. And sometimes when she'd had her fill, she'd dance a Highland fling. When O'Brien took a drop himself, he'd join her in a song. And a happier pair you never saw, they'd sing the whole night long. Give the woman in the bed more porter. Give the woman in the bed more porter. Ah, give the woman in the bed more porter. Give the woman in the bed more porter. Before she wrecks the house. Fantastic, ladies and gentlemen. Let's sing Galway Bay. Do you know Galway Bay? Clap, how many people have seen Galway Bay? Very impressed. Clap, anybody has been to my home city of Cork? That's good enough. But here's Galway Bay, made famous by the one and only Bing Crosby. Okay? Oh, and maybe someday I'll go back to Ireland. If only at the closing of my day, to see again the moon rise over clutter and watch the sun go down on Galway Bay, to see again the ripple of a trout stream and workers in the meadows making hay. Sit beside a turf fire in a cabin and watch the children barefoot as they play. Are the winds that blow across the bogs of Ireland are perfumed by the heather as they blow, and the women in the uplands digging praties speak a language that the strangers do not know. Yes, the strangers came and tried to teach us their ways and scorned us for being what we are. Well, they might as well go chasing after moonbeams or light a penny candle from a star. Oh, and if there's gonna be a life hereafter, and somehow I feel sure there's gonna be, I will ask my Lord to let me make my heaven in that dear land across the Irish Sea. Oh, yeah. And up Galway, if anybody's here from Galway. Thank you very, very much, ladies and gentlemen. This is a little song, ladies and gentlemen. It's called Come to the Cailee. And it's a little sort of a dance they do in Ireland. Like you go, you have your partner go, one, two, three, hop and a one, two, three, hop and a one. It's sort of like a polka, one, two, three. And if anybody wants to do it, I challenge you. One, and you've got your partner, of course, like one, two, three, hop and a one, two, three, hop, you know? So this is a little tune that has that tempo in it, little bit of fun. It's called Come to the Cailee, and here we go. Anybody wants to dance now, you have to do it that way. If your heart's sick and lonesome and you want to cry, with thoughts all as gloomy with the winter sky, just take my advice and put your best suit on and come to the Cailee down in Derry Vaughan. For 'tis there you find music to your heart's desire, a glass full of liquor and a seat beside a roaring fire. So come to the Cailee and you'll weep no more, forget all your troubles as you pass the door. Sure, your way won't be lonesome as we travel on, The long road would shorten with the cheery song. You'll be fit like Nazy as a skipping fall if you come to the Cayley down in Derry Vaughan. For 'tis there you'll find music to your heart's desire, a glass full of liquor and a seat beside a roaring fire. So come to the Cayley and you'll weep no more. Forget all your troubles as you pass the door. Hang on one sec. There'll be colleagues to meet you with a smiling face, to dance you till morning with a modest grace. There'll be Kid Mila Folger and a Kushkin Law. If you come to the Cayley down, don't go away. For us there you'll find music to your heart's desire, a glass full of liquor and a seat beside a roaring fire. So come to the Cayley and you'll weep no more. Forget all your troubles as you pass the door. Here for Paddy. If your heart's sick and lonesome and you want to cry, with thoughts all as gloomy as a winter sky, just take my advice and put your best suit on and come to the Cayley down in Derry Vaughan. For 'tis there you'll find music to your heart's desire, a glass full of liquor and a seat of roaring fire. So come to the Cayley and you'll weep no more. Forget all your troubles as you pass the door. So come to the Cayley and you'll weep no more. Forget all your troubles and you pass the door. Woo! Well done. Let's hear for that couple. Where do you come from?
Killarney.
Killarney of Kerry. Fair play to you.
I come from Kerry.
What?
I need to know how many Irish there are in here.
I'd say all of us tonight. Yes.
Raise their hand. How many Irish we have here in this old place? Raise your right hand. Raise your hand.
We're all Irish tonight.
Good for you. Good for you. Well, up Kerry anyway, ladies and gentlemen. Here's a beautiful tune, ladies and gentlemen. I'm proud to say, written by a friend of mine. He was until this tune, a struggling songwriter in Ireland, and he never gave up. And he got a melody from a Norwegian gentleman, and he was asked to write the words, and he wrote this incredible tune called You Raise Me Up. And this song is very, very special to a lot of people, and I understand why. So, gorgeous song, half Irish, half Norwegian, one of the best songs to come along in many a day, perhaps. And it's called You Raise Me Up. And after this, we're going to have our dancers back again, ladies and gentlemen. So here we go. Troubles come and my heart burden be, then I am still and waiting in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on my stormy sees. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be. When I am on your shoulders, you raise me up to more than I can be. There is no night without its hunger. Each restless heart beats so imperfectly, but when you come and I am filled with wonder, sometimes I think I glimpse eternity. I can stand on mountains.
Raise me up to walk on stormy seas.
And I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be. What a beautiful song, ladies and gentlemen, written by Brendan Graham and Ralph Loveland in Ireland. If you don't mind, ladies and gentlemen, I have a tiny little present to give to the lovely owner here, Mrs. Madonia. I came in last night and I saw this beautiful place, and then I went to my bedroom and I couldn't believe the beautiful bedroom. If I had taste, I'd want it to be exactly as yours. Because you have fantastic taste. So this is, forgive the masculine presentation without the flowery paper. It's a little print from Ireland. Just, oh, go away out of that. I'm honored to know you. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, okay. Sorry. Oh, excuse me. The show will continue in a second, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. It was fabulous.
How long are you going to be around this area?
Oh, I got to go to Connecticut tomorrow.
Oh, what a shame.
I know.
So, ladies and gentlemen, just a small thank you. I appreciate it. We're going to have, if you wouldn't mind, ladies and gentlemen, especially the people on this side, if you want to just come around a little bit and have a look at these fantastic dancers, if you wouldn't mind, come on over, because they are really, really worth seeing. Anybody can do this, you know? And I can say I'm dancing, but these people really do dance. So come on over and come to the wall, as we say, and have a look. So, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Sarah. She's going to start off. Face whichever way you wish. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, for your pleasure, our lovely Irish dancers. Let's hear them once again, please. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, that was Casey and Kerry. Let's hear it for them, please. They're fantastic. They'll be back to open our second half. Do you like it? Made in Scotland, ladies and gentlemen. And for all the Scottish people here, I hope you'll enjoy my little tribute to your homeland. We Irish and the Scots are the same blood, as you know, the Celts. And so a few songs, gentlemen, just a bit of fun, beginning with a song called I Love a Lassie, and it goes like this. Here we go. You want to clap your hands, everybody? Let's have a bit of fun. Come on. Here we go.
Oh, I love a lassie, a bonny, bonny lassie. She's as pure as the lily in the dell. She's as sweet as the heather, the bonny, bonny heather. Mary, my Scots bluebell. Oh, I love a lassie, hello, a bonny, bonny lassie. She's as pure as the lily, hi sir, in the dell. She's as sweet, I'm so sorry, the bonny, bonny heather.
Mary, my Scots bluebell, hello. Oh, Roman in the gloamin', on the... I'm fine, how are you? Good. Roman in the gloamin' with my lassie by my side. Hi. When the sun goes down to rest, that's the time I love the best.
Good, I'm Barbara from Sweetwater.
Oh, Roman in the gloamin', on the bunny banks of Clyde. Roman.
I'll talk to you later.
When the sun goes down to rest, hi, that's the time I love the best, sir. Oh, it's lovely, Roman in the gloamin'. Hello. Just a wee Dioch and Doris. Sweet Drogh and Doris, afore we gone awa. Hello, with a wee wifey waiting. Which?
Oh,
okay. It's all right, I say. Just a wee Dioch and Doris. Just a wee Drogh, that's all. Doris, afore we gone awa. Hello. With a wee wifey waiting. Yes, sir. What? Oh, the two little boys, yeah. And it's all right. Hello, everybody. Just a wee. Up the Irish. Hello. Hello. Nice to see you. Hi there. Good to see you. Hello. Hark, when the night is calling, hear, hear, the pipes are calling, loudly and proudly calling down through the glen. Hello. There where the hills are sleeping, now feel the blood a-leaping, high as the spirits of the old Highlandmen. Hello. Towering in gallant fame, Scotland, my mountain home, high may your proud standards gloriously wave. Hello again. Land of my high endeavour. Land of my heart forever, Scotland the brave. Hello. Okay. High in the Glasgow mountains, brave are the hearts that beat. Hello again, neat Scottish skies. Wild are the winds to meet you, staunch are the friends that greet you, kind as hello love that shines from fair maiden's eyes. Towering in gallant fame, Scotland, my mountain hang, high may your proud standards gloriously wave. Hello. Land of my high endeavor, land of the shining river, land of my heart forever, Scotland the brave. Hey, thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Here's another one called Donald, Where's Your Trousers? And that's your line. I've just come down from the Isle of Skye. I'm no very big and I'm awful shy. The lassies shout when I go by, Donald, where's your trousers? Let the wind blow high, let the wind blow low, through the streets in my kilt I'll go. All the lassies say, hello, Donald, where's your trousers? A lassie took me to a ball, and it was slippery in the hall, and I was feared that I would fall, for I had me on me trousers. Let the wind blow high, let the wind blow low, through the streets in my kilt I'll go. All the lassies say, hello! Now I went down to London town, and I had some fun in the underground. The ladies turned their heads around, saying, Donald, where are your trousers? Let the wind blow high, let the wind blow low, through the streets in my kilt I'll go. All the lassies say, hello! To wear the kilt is my delight. It is not wrong, I know it's right. The islanders would get a fright if they saw me in the trousers. Let the wind blow high, let the wind blow low, through the streets of my kilt I'll go. All the lassies say, hello! The lassies want me, everyone. Well, let them catch me if you can. You cannot keep a brick on the heel of man, and I don't wear the trousers. Let the wind blow high, let the wind blow low, through the streets of my kilt I'll go. All the lassies say, hello! Donald, where's your trousers? Donagh, well, that's the way we sing the song in Scotland, don't you know? But of course, the song might have more commercial appeal sung something like this. Well, I've just come down from the Isle of Skye. I'm no very big and I'm awful shy. The lassie shout when I go by. Donald. Let the wind blow, let the wind blow. Through the streets of my Kildare go. Oh yeah, go, 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 hey Donald. I'm man, I'm all rock and roll. Moving and grooving to save my soul. Grab your Kildare and go, 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 hey Donald. Let the wind blow, let the wind blow. Through the streets of my Kildare go. Oh yeah, go, 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 hey Donald. Hey Donald. Hey, 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 just a minute. What are you doing there? Man, I'm rocking it, man. I'm really moving it, man. Well, you just stop rocking it and moving it, man. The song should be sung exactly like this. I've just come down, come on. I'm a sky, I'm no very big, and I'm awful shy. The lassies shout when I go by. Let the wind blow high, let the wind blow low. Through the streets in my kilt I'll go. All the lassies say hello. Donald, where's your trousers? Oh, yeah. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very, very, very much. We'll take a small little break, ladies and gentlemen, and very quickly, just outside, in case you want to know, there are some CDs out there. They're $15 each. End of story. If you buy two, you get my comedy album free, and that's about it. If you want to come to Ireland, there's a yellow flyer outside. Lovely trip to Ireland in June and September. If you're fun. If you're not fun, for God's sake, don't come with us. So we'll be back in about 10 minutes, ladies and gentlemen. Have a little relax, and thank you very, very, very much. Appreciate it very much. Thank you. Thank you. You like the tails, ladies and gentlemen? Made in America. Made in Pennsylvania near State College, a little town called Phillipsburg, actually. And the reason why I bought these tails specifically was a few years ago, my wife and our little boy were in Heinz Hall in Pittsburgh with the Pittsburgh Symphony Orchestra waiting to accompany one of the greats, Victor Borge. And Victor, God rest him, his legs were gone, was coming to the end of his, he was about 93 almost, still playing magnificently, couldn't, you know, and he sort of shuffled towards the piano. And when he got to the grand piano, I noticed he had this beautiful tails in him. He did this with his tails, like that. And the whole place went wild. So I'm going to do that again now. Fair play. Here's a little bit of Tchaikovsky. Thank you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Tchaikovsky, whoever just turned in his grave. I have a couple of requests for people who have seen me here in Florida before to sing this next song. This is a song, ladies and gentlemen, called My Son. And thank you. I met my wife, Kathleen. She's from New Jersey. She's from Haddon Heights near Philadelphia in Cape May, New Jersey, 19 years ago. We actually got a little bit of bad news about Kathleen. We just found out she lost her credit card and somebody's using it. I know. I didn't cancel, though, but because he's spending way less than she does. The hell is Lord and Taylor? But anyway, 19 years ago we met, and 18 years ago we got married, and 17 years ago we had a little baby boy, in that order, which pleased my mother greatly. And I probably would have been married a long, long time ago in Ireland were it not for my mother, because she sabotaged every poor, unfortunate girl that ever came into our house. If I was going with a dark-haired girl, after a while she'd meet her, of course. I'd say, well, Ma, what do you think? She says, no, Cahal, no. She's too dull. You get tired of her too quickly. And a blonde, oh, she'd buy and sell you, boy. She's way too quick for you altogether. And I remember one time about 25 years ago, I was dancing in Cork City one night. I saw a girl. She was the image of my mother. Now, granted, she was younger, of course. And I said, right, I brought her home. And my father hated her. What the heck do you do? But anyway, about a month before our little guy, and we called our little guy Ryan. And if you have a Ryan in your family, ladies and gentlemen, that's Irish for king. In case you didn't know, king. Friends of ours gave me this next song called My Son. And they said, if it's a boy, you might like to sing this in your show. And I had a listen, and sure, you can't relate to this until you have a child, you know. And I thought it was pretty corny, to be honest with you. But then a month later, I was at the birth, and this beautiful, miraculous, total, unconditional love, of course, took over in bucketfuls. I was worried would it happen to me, but sure, I didn't have to worry at all. And I listened to the song again, and it was a whole new song. And I've never heard a better lyric describing what it's like to have a child than this particular one, and it's called My Son. So thank you for asking for it. Here we go, My Son. Son, you were the seed of life in me, and now I can't believe the man I see. With pride I watch you grow up. You wanted so much to change the world for me, my son. You gave my simple life its key. Through you I see God's love and mystery. You build up my life with your sweet music. It's written in the song, this melody belongs to you and me, my son. Son, I taught you everything I know. For soon, one day I'll have to let you go. I would gladly die if it saved you from the heartaches, the fears, and all the bad breaks that tear your world apart. My son, you faced the truth and you stood tall. And now we face the hardest truth of all. I must say goodbye, but you must go on living. And when my life is through, I'll always be with you, my own beloved son. I watch you now with pride. What more is there to life than you and me, my son? Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Really nice. And now, my friends, it's time for our Irish step dancers one more time for their final dance. And they're bringing their younger sister, Molly, here. And they're going to do a reel. So please welcome Casey, Sarah, and Molly, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. Gentlemen, Casey, Sarah, and Molly. Fantastic. Really, really spectacular. Thank you, ladies. Wow. Isn't that something else, ladies and gentlemen? Such discipline. And as I said, they go to Ireland and they compete against the Irish dancers and sometimes they beat them. So it's marvelous to keep the culture alive. Some of the songs you know, ladies and gentlemen. In Dublin's fair city, where the girls are so, I first set me eyes on sweet Molly Malone, as she wheeled a wheelbarrow through streets broad and narrow, crying cockles and mussels alive, alive, oh, alive, alive, oh, alive, alive, oh, crying cockles and mussels, alive, alive, oh. She was a fishmonger, and sure 'twas no wonder, for so were her father and mother before. As they wheeled their wheelbarrows through streets broad and narrow, crying cockles and mussels, alive, alive, oh, alive, alive, oh, alive, alive, oh, crying cockles and mussels, alive, alive, oh. I'll take you home again, Kathleen, across the oceans far and wide. And why your heart has ever been, since first you were my bunny bride. The roses all have left your cheeks, I've watched them fade away and die. Your voice is sad wherever you speak, and tears bedim your loving eyes. Oh, I will take you home, Kathleen, to where your heart will feel no pain. And when the fields are fresh and green, I will take you to your home, Kathleen. The whistling gypsy came over the hill, down through the valley so shady. He whistled and sang till the green woods rang, and he won the heart of the lady. Ah-dee-doo, ah-dee-doo, da-day, ah-dee-doo, ah-dee-day-dee. He whistled and sang till the green woods rang, and he won the heart of the lady. He is no gypsy, my father dear, he's lord of these lands all over. And I will stay till my dying day with my whistling gypsy rover. Ah-dee-doo, ah-dee-doo, da-dee, ah-dee-doo, ah-dee-dee-dee. He whistled and sang till the green woods rang, and he won the heart of the lady. To the best of my knowledge, ladies and gentlemen, that is the only happy love song that Ireland ever came out of Ireland. She fell in love, and she was happy ever after. Usually they die, they drown, she leaves him, he leaves her, he gets killed in battle. But anyway, Mrs. Casey, ladies and gentlemen. I'm not Mrs. Casey. Yes, she was about 60, 86 or 87. She was living up in a lovely part of Ireland called County Mayo, in the northwest coast. And she was on her own. Her husband had long gone off to his reward up in heaven, and the kids were doing their own thing. And she's slowly coming up the little boring to the cottage one Sunday morning. And what does she see with this back turned to her? A leprechaun. My God, she thought she'd never see a leprechaun. She thought, you know, that was just for the tourists. But there he was, about 2 feet tall, wearing my green tuxedom, the cheek of him. And if he can catch a leprechaun and hang on to him, he's got to hand over the pot of gold or grant you 3 wishes. So she creeps up, and even though she's 86, 87, she's still milking the cows and saving the hay. She's strong as a horse. And she grabs him and hangs on for dear life. All right, all right, all right, she says, what the hell do you want? Which is any chance at all, she says, of a little bit of money. And money just poured down from the heavens, thousands and thousands of pounds. So naturally, she got more ambitious. She said, there'll be any chance at all, she says, you could make me young and pretty again like I was 60 years ago. And poof, she was gorgeous. And then she saw her cat going by. See that old cat of mine there? any chance at all you could turn him into a fabulous hunk of an Irishman that would love me. And poof, this Brad Pitt vision of a fella came out of this cat. She was amazed. And she says, "Are you Murphy?" And he said, "I am. And I bet you're sorry now you had me fixed." Thank you. I got another request, ladies and gentlemen, from another gentleman that saw me a few years ago, and he'd like to hear a song called Two Little Boys, and I think you'd like to hear it as well. It's a terrific tune from, it's rather obscure, but it's from the Civil War here, a few short years before the Civil War. The two little boys in question, Jack and Joe, are playing soldiers with toy horses. And suddenly Jack's horse's head falls off and he's devastated. And his pal Jack says, or Joe says, "Hop up on my horse, Jack, so we can go as fast on one as two." And he completely forgets about the little favor he did for his friend, but his pal never did. And a few short years later, they're in the thick of battle. And even he sees his pal Joe pretty badly injured on the battlefield. And even though they're on opposite sides, as happened so much, he charges out bravely amidst, as you veterans know, the indiscriminate bullets, and he rescues his pal. And that's the nice message. The bigger message, I think, is man's love for his fellow man, despite all the madness we create against each other. And as you know, war is orchestrated by the few, but always paid for by so many, sadly. So anyway, ladies and gentlemen, thanks for asking for it. Two Little Boys, here we go. Thank you. Two little boys had two little toys, each had a wooden horse. Gaily they played each summer's day, warriors both, of course. One little chap then had a mishap, broke off his horse's head. Wept for his toy, then cried with joy when his young playmate said, "Did you think I would leave you crying when there's room on my horse for two? Climb up here, Jack, we'll soon be flying. I can go just as fast with two. When we grow up, we'll both be soldiers, and our horses will not be toys. And I wonder, will we remember when we were two little boys?" Long years passed, war came so fast. One wore blue, the other gray. Cannons roared loud, and in the mad crowd, wounded and dying lay. Up goes a shout, a horse dashes out, out from the ranks so blue. Gallops away to where Joe lay, then came a voice he knew. "Did you think I would leave you dying when there's room on my horse for two? Climb up here, Joe, we'll soon be flying. I can go just as fast with two. You see, Joe, I'm all a tremble. Perhaps it's the battle's noise, but I think it's that I remember when we were two little boys. Did you think I would leave you dying when there's room on my horse for two? Climb up here, Joe, we'll soon be flying. I can go just as fast with two. You see, Joe, I'm all a tremble. Perhaps it's the battle's noise, but I think it's that I remember when we were two little boys." Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. That's rather nice, isn't it? Thank you. Two more to go, my friends, but there's a drink in Ireland. It looks like this. It's called poitchin. P-O-I-T-I-N, or the English version, P-O-T-C-H-E-E-N. And truly, if you drank that much of it, you wouldn't make it out of here alive. It's our moonshine, you know? And the closest thing I've ever drank near it, of course, apart from the West Virginia moonshine, and that's not as good, seriously now, in as much as it's more turpentine-y, to put it, you know, the best way. The closest thing I've ever come to this poitchin in Ireland is an Italian drink, which is pretty very good, called grappa. And they have it here in this place, which is incredibly, amazingly marvelous. But to the best of my knowledge, that is 40% proof, ladies and gentlemen. Poitchin is 70% proof. It's 140%, but 70% alcohol, which is amazing. The farmers, when they run with the greyhounds, you know, when they spit it into their face just before the greyhounds run, the greyhounds go mad altogether. It's completely illegal to drink it in Ireland, you know, but it's a great drink. And if you have a jar of honey, mix it with it, and you'll never get a finer liqueur in all your life than poitchin and honey. A friend of mine, she's Swiss, she's retired in Blarney, she called it honey schnapps. But this is a little tune about a fella called Paddy O'Reilly from County Kerry, who brewed the poitchin a long, long time ago, about 50 years ago. He was very famous, and he was so famous that when he died, his friends wrote him this song in his memory, which is an incredible compliment from one Irishman to another, because normally when you're going into the grave, do you know what his pals are doing? They're checking out how his wife is looking. That's what they're doing. Shameless altogether. But this little bit of nonsense called Don't Bother to Knock. And when I come to the part, Don't Bother to Knock, if you feel like it, you clap your hands twice like, Don't Bother to Knock, clap, clap, Don't Bother to Knock, clap, clap. You have it. So here we go. Have you heard about O'Reilly from the town of Ballyduff? They say he's got the finest ale that ever brewed the stuff. If you want to sip the Mountain Dew, you go there any day. When Riley hears you coming, he would lift his voice and say, Don't bother to knock, don't bother to knock. Just lift the latch and walk right in, me boy. Don't bother to knock, don't bother to knock. Come in and make yourself at home. Now the quality of Riley's brew led quickly to his fame, and soon the local sergeant vowed he'd stop his little game. He jumped upon his bicycle and raced on Riley's way, and to his most officious knock he heard O'Reilly say, Don't bother to knock, don't bother to knock. Just lift the latch and walk right in, me boy. Don't bother to knock, don't bother to knock. Come in and make yourself at home. Now when Riley stood before the judge, he hoped he would be fine. But soon he found that Wiley judge was not the drinking kind. He packed O'Reilly off to jail with very small delay. When Riley reached the prison gates, he heard the warden say, Don't bother to knock, don't bother to knock. Just lift the latch and walk. Your turn, come on. Come in and make yourself at home. Well, there's lots of lamentations in the place near Ballyduff. Should they say that no one's ever brewed the likes of Riley stuff? When Riley ran his earthly course and reached the promised land, they say St. Peter sang and danced and took him by the hand. Don't bother to knock, don't bother to knock. Just lift the latch and walk right in, your turn. Come in and make yourself at home. Well, now that's the life of Riley, and it's very pleasant end. They say that up in heaven he's St. Patrick's greatest friend, and that's a fact. Sure, 'tis Riley's brew that drove the snakes from Erin's lovely shore. That's why this Irish welcome waits for you at heaven's door. Don't bother to knock, don't bother to knock. Just lift the latch and walk right in. Take it away. come in and make yourself at home. Don't bother to knock.
Lovely stuff, everybody.
Really nice, ladies and gentlemen. Okay. Okay. I don't know that song. No, I do not know. I'm so sorry. I don't know that song. I wish I did. A Little Shamrock. I don't know the one. So, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to say goodnight with this last few little medleys. I have been very fortunate to live in America. I was a piano teacher for a little while in Ireland out of college and writing a few songs here and there, hoping for something. And then the recession came along and sort of everything tanked. Basically, Ireland is booming again, I'm glad to say. But I was glad to come to this country because otherwise I'd have been a piano teacher for the rest of my life. Can you imagine every half an hour giving the kids a lesson? So it was an easy decision, even though I don't have a cousin in this country, which is unusual. But I would like to do a tribute to the veterans, because without you gentlemen, mostly gentlemen, we wouldn't have it as good as we have. And the world would have taken a much darker turn, I'm convinced. Wouldn't you agree? So, humbly, I will not even try and talk about what it was like to be a veteran, because I wasn't there. But I admire you. I'm in awe of you. And I'm amazed at how you do it, and actually how you are so humble about it all. So, with respect to the veterans and our great Red, White and Blue, I'll say thanks to the Red Rose Inn and Suites. I had a fantastic time here last night and today with all the people, very, very friendly staff and all the gang, and my friend PJ Leary and his great band. So to you all, ladies and gentlemen, as we say in Ireland, any day above ground is a good one. And I sincerely wish you a happy St. Patrick's Day, and thank you for listening. And thank you for coming. And hopefully we'll meet down the road again.
We would like to invite you down for breakfast tomorrow morning, Cahal, and have some Lucky Charms on
us.
Oh,
wow.
Okay.
That's great. That's wonderful. I'll have them. But I'm going to just change into my final jacket, ladies and gentlemen, of the evening with respect to our flag. Just one sec. So I went from the green to the red, white, and blue. Do you like it? I like it too. A friend of mine said, it's a nice jacket. He says, but you look like a barcode. I said, what the heck did he say that for? Why does he have to put you down, huh? But I like them. So here are four songs specifically for World War II, from World War II and World War I, but they are dedicated to all the veterans. So good night, ladies and gentlemen, from Cahal Dunne. It's alcohol without the L. See ya. Kia G, let's go. Here we go. Thank you so much.
We'll meet again. Don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Keep smiling through, just like you always do, till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away. So won't you please say hello to the folks that I know, tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing a song. again. But I know we'll meet again some sunny day. There'll be bluebirds over your turn, cliffs of Dover tomorrow. Just you wait and see. There'll be love and laughter and peace ever after tomorrow, when the world is free. The shepherd will tend his sheep, the valley will bloom again, and Jimmy will go to sleep in his own little room again. There'll be bluebirds over. Tomorrow, just you wait and see. Underneath the lamplight by the barricade, darling, I remember it's there you used to wait, there where you whispered tenderly that you love me, you'll always be my lily of the lamplight, my only Marlene. Time has come for roll call, time for us to part. Darling, I'll caress you and press you to my heart. There where that lamplight softly beams, your sweet voice seems to haunt my dreams, my lily of the lamplight, my own. My lily of the lamplight, my only Marlene. Little bit of a march now, ladies and gentlemen. Woo! Over there. Over there, send the word over there, that the Yanks are coming, the Yanks are coming, the drums rum drumming everywhere, so prepare, say a prayer, send the word to beware, we'll be over, we're coming over, and we won't be back till it's over, over there,
let's hear ya.
Send the word over there, that the Yanks are coming, the Yanks are coming, the drums run tumming everywhere, so prepare, say a prayer, send the word to beware, we'll be over, we're coming over, and we won't be back till it's over, over there.
Thank you to the veterans, to all of you. God bless, ladies and gentlemen. It was a pleasure. Take care of yourselves. And we're going to have my friend, PJ
Leary and his lovely great band together in a few minutes. God bless you. Happy St. Patrick's Day. And thank you so, so much.